we offer you a video manual of annual testing of the avionic emergency locator transmitter. The ELT has to be tested every 12 months to confirm that it is operational as defined in appropriate performance standards. We have the ELTS taken from the aircraft, disconnected from antenna and dashboard. First of all, check the battery's expiration date and replace if necessary. To confirm the ELT is operational and correctly encoded, we should measure its operational parameters using a special ELT tester I406 Mini. ELT tester Mini standard set includes antenna, attenuator, connection cables, and connectors TNC and BNC. So we connect the ELT through the attenuator. You will need a mobile device with Wi-Fi technology. Please notice you don't need internet connection. ELT tester has internal server and the operator can connect to it through Wi-Fi link created by the tester. Turn on the tester. It creates Wi-Fi link. We use a smartphone to connect it in a usual way. The blue light here indicates that the connection is established. Now open any browser that can work without internet connection. Input the IP address of I406 Mini, which is typed here, or simply scan the QR code. Here is the menu of the tester. Let's perform tests. First, select the test mode. Attenuator. Select the test channel 406 MHz first, press Start New Test button and turn on the ELT. Wait for signal receive. It's done. Let's view what we measured. Its frequency in kHz, power level in dBm, complete message content in hex format, country code, ELT operation mode, BCH code verified, message format, protocol type, serial number of the beacon, coordinates, unmodulated carrier, and total transmission time. The result can be saved now and each channel measurements can be saved independently. But to have all channels information in one test report, we make tests on all the channels one by one. So we go on by testing 121.5 MHz channel. Press here and send the signal from the ELT. Here is the audio confirmation of signal present. ELT tester Mini received the signal and we see the measured frequency and power level. Finally, we do the same for the 243 MHz channel. Start the test. We hear audio confirmation of its presence. What results we have got? Here are frequency in kilohertz and power level in dBm. By pressing save button, we save all the measurements in three channels. And we have them stored in internal memory of the tester, which is 4 GB. For the case ELT has test mode, we recommend to provide also the testing through the broadcast with help of antenna. For this purpose, keep the ELT connected to the dashboard and antenna. The testing is to be provided out of the aircraft and the antenna of the ELT has to be in observable distance. The procedure of measurements is the same as with the attenuator, just use the antenna mode. After all parameters are checked, we have right to make test report. In menu, select test results. Open the corresponding test result file and see test results. Input the aircraft details here and press General Report. Ready, the report is generated automatically. It can be printed just now or save the report in HTML or RTF format. Then
you are able to put your logo and company details on the document. Here is ready test report.
We hope we've managed to make this video manual helpful for all our customers and friends.